So I started the recording also. So no need for you to worry. So let's wait for 5 more minutes for others to join. Okay, then we will start the session. So I hope everyone has got the PDF with them. Fine. So if anyone has not got the PDF, message me or call me, because after 5 minutes I'll be muting my mobile phone. So if there is any disconnection, no need to worry. Okay. So I'm still waiting for the people to join properly and then go. So I hope we will start the class now. Okay, so good morning guys. And I would highly recommend, first of all, not everyone to go out till the lockdown period is over. Okay, and second most thing, today we are going to discuss about chemistry. So a lot of guys might have felt chemistry is very difficult in class 12, but in entrance examination, chemistry is the most easiest compared to physics and maths. Okay, because the questions are direct questions. And once you read the NCERT book line by line, we can get the answers very easily. Okay. And I would also suggest that a lot of your friends might be unable to join any classes for the KSET. So you can also tell them to join my class. Okay, so that they will get benefited out of this lockdown period. Fine. Okay. So let's start the class today. Fine. And the class has been recorded and I'll edit and send it to you. So I hope everyone is having the paper with you. So keep it ready. So first question, I'll be discussing about the question number 5. Which of the following is incorrect in a galvanic cell? Which of the following is incorrect in a galvanic cell? So before going through this thing, let us take Daniel's cell. Okay, let us take a Daniel's cell. So what happens at Daniel's cell? There is two things. At anode, what happens at anode? Oxidation happens. Oxidation means what? Loss of electrons. Loss of electrons. So Zn gives Zn2 plus plus 2e minus. And this electrons is accepted at what? Cathode. So at cathode, what happens? Reduction happens. Reduction meaning gain of electrons. Gain of electrons. So Cu2 plus plus 2e minus will give you means what? 2Cu or whatever it is. So now we don't need to worry about the balancing and everything. We just want to apply the concept and get the answer. Okay. So I want everyone to note down these two these things which I written on the board. Okay. So just to give you a overall view. So please note it down. This thing. This is a conceptual thing. This is our concept. At anode, oxidation happens, there is loss of electrons, and at cathode, reduction happens, it is gain of electrons. Gain of electrons. So this 2e plus is actually taken by what? Cu2 plus. This in Daniel's cell, there is nothing but our galvanic cell in the question. So I want everyone to note down the same thing. And chemistry is the most easiest of all. Okay, because we'll get direct questions and direct answer. So I hope everyone has written down the same thing. Then I'll come back to the question. Which of the following is incorrect in a galvanic cell? Oxidation occurs at anode. Question is incorrect. And here we follow a very important process in entrance exam that is called process of elimination. Elimination. Question is incorrect. But at anode oxidation happens, that is correct. Reduction occurs at cathode. That is also correct. Let us look at the fourth point. The electrons at which electrons are lost is called cathode. No, at anode only we lose the electrons. The third point. Third point is what? The electrons at which electrons are gained. Correct. Gain of electrons is at cathode. So obviously the answer is what? Option D for us. So here we follow process of elimination. Process of elimination. This is what most important for us. Process of elimination. So question number 5, option D. Now let us take question number 8. the amount of current in Faraday is required for the reduction of one mole of Cr2O7 2 minus ions to Cr3 plus ions is what? 1 Faraday, 2 Faraday, 6 Faraday or 4 Faraday? So before going to this question, we should know the concept of, what is the concept? Oxidation number. Okay, let us take water H2O, and we don't know the oxidation number or oxygen state of oxygen, so we'll take this as what? X. Hydrogen, how many atoms are there? 1. So 1 into 2 plus X is equal to 0. So what is X value? X is equal to minus 2. So oxidation number or oxygen state, oxidation number or oxidation state, both are same, okay, of oxygen in water is what? Minus 2. Let us take hydrogen peroxide, H2O2. So here it will be what? 2 into 1, 1 molecule of hydrogen, plus 2 molecules of oxygen, 2 into X. If you want to find the oxidation state of oxygen, 2 into X is equal to what? 0. So 2 plus 2X is equal to what? 0. So X is equal to minus 1. So this is what you've been taught in class 11 in redox reaction. Okay, that chapter. X is equal to minus 2 and X is equal to minus 1 respectively. X is equal to minus 2 and X is equal to minus 1 respectively. So everyone note down the two things. In water and hydrogen peroxide. Okay, so this is for people who don't know this particular thing, okay? This is for the person who doesn't remember the thing. And guys, these kind of questions are very, very important in entrance. At least one kind of question will come. Maybe two questions will come. And organic chemistry, I don't want you to stress much in it. Maximum 5 to 6 questions will come, that's all. Out of 60, maximum 5 or 6 questions, or to 7, that's it. So mostly physical and inorganic chemistry will come. So kindly focus more on the physical chemistry, inorganic chemistry to get 50 plus out of the 60 questions. So out of 60 questions, how much you should get? 50 plus, that's all. So I hope everyone has written down the same thing. Now coming to the question. 8th one, Cr2O7 2 minus. So what is the oxygen state of chromium in this? Plus 6. Because oxygen I'm giving as what? What I'm giving is oxygen? Minus 2. So general oxygen state of oxygen is what? Minus 2. So we'll get plus 6. And this chromium, I'll get what? Cr3 plus. Already it's given. It is plus 3. Fine. So, it shows a change in the oxidation number. Correct? So, that is what? Change of 3 moles of electron per 1 mole of chromium atom. Per 1 mole of chromium atom. Okay, but guys, let us take our Cr2O7 2 minus. How many moles are there? This contains 2 moles of chromium atom. So for 1 mole of chromium atom, it is what? Plus 3. There is a change of 3. Correct? See, change of 3 moles of electron per 1 mole of chromium atom. But here we got 2 mole. But here we got only 1 mole. So for 2 moles, what you should do? 2 into 3, answer is what? 6. So the answer is 6 farads for this. So again, we have to see the number of molecules here. So we should not directly jump on and write 3 farads as the answer. Okay, because here we got Cr2. Cr2 meaning what? 2 moles of chromium atom. So two in for one molecule, for one mole of chromium atom, it is what? 3 mole of electron. So 2 mole, how many moles of electron need? We need 6 moles, that is 6 farads. That's all. You kindly copy this thing down. So first I am going with the most important thing, then the least important things in this. So chemistry, we got lot of direct answers. Okay, lot and lot of direct answers. And for the guys who started new today, okay, so I'll just tell you how to prepare. Take one chapter at a time. Okay, take one chapter at a time. For example, chemistry, if you're taking, let us take polymers or some other thing. Okay, so if you're taking that thing, take the chemistry NCERT exercise chapter. Chemistry NCERT exercise. Okay, chemistry NCERT exercise chapter you take. Then what we should do? We should solve all the questions in that. Then take the chemistry exemplar, only of one chapter per day. Take like that, and then you can slowly increase up the pace. Okay, so currently take only one chapter per day and do the exercise and exemplar. And once the class is over, revise the same questions which I taught today. That's all. So I hope everyone has written down the same. So let us take the 9th question now. For a chemical reaction, MA gives XB, the rate law is R is equal to KA square. If the concentration of A is doubled, the reaction is what? So I'll just do it on the whiteboard. So it's given what? R is equal to K into A square. Correct? Which means what? R proportional to A square. So when the concentration of A is doubled, when the concentration of A is doubled, okay, R proportional to what? 2A the whole square, doubled. So this is equal to what? 4 into A square. Hence the rate becomes what? Quadrupled. Hence, rate becomes quadrupled respectively. Quadrupled respectively. So, please note down the same. This for the question 9. The rate becomes quadrupled. So guys, if you have got any doubt, you can just keep it at the last. Okay. At the last 5-10 minutes, I'll give you time to ask me all the questions. So this is a very easy question for us to do. Okay. So I hope everyone has written down the same. So I'm going to the next question. So I'll try to do as many problems as today. Okay. Then maybe some shortcuts I'll teach you. But chemistry, we don't have major shortcuts. We have to know the concept properly. So for that, inside a textbook, each and every line we have to be thorough. But I already told you in the first question and second question, what I mentioned in the first and second question, I clearly told like what oxidation number is very, very important. We will get questions from that. Okay. And second thing is what the cells, we should know what is oxidation. We should know what is reduction. What is anode? Anode, what happens? Oxidation happens. Anox. Reduction, what happens? Cathode. Okay. Red cat. Like that, you can learn a lot of techniques. So the ninth one, the option is what? B, quadruplet. Let us take the 11th one. For 3A to 2B, the rate of reaction plus dB by dt is equal to what? So first I'll write the reaction. For the reaction 3A to 2B, correct? Now what is the question? Minus 1 by 3 dA by dt is equal to what? 1 by 2 what dB by dt. This dA by dt, this is dB by dt. Therefore, what is our dB by dt is equal to? dB by dt is equal to 2 by 3 dA by dt. See, if you don't write square brackets here, no problem, okay? Minus 2 by 3. So negative 2 by 3. If you don't write a square bracket, there is not at all a problem here. So this is the answer. So this is not our board exam where handwriting should be given more importance, but mostly of what? We should get the answers fast, quick enough. That's all. This is hardly a 10 seconds answer if you know the concept. Minus 2 by 3 dA by dt. So if everyone has copied down, I'll go to the next one. For reactant, obviously we'll put minus 1 by 3. This is 1 by 2 dB by dt. Just rearrange it, that's all. What is dB by dt? This 2 will go this side. Minus 2 by 3 dA by dt. As easy as step by, that's all. Very easy. And trust me, chemistry is the most easiest one. Okay. Let us take question number 13. Which of the following statement is incorrect with respect to physics option? So again, see the options here. The forces involved are van der Waals forces. In physical adsorption, it is true. Okay, this is true that this is correct. More easily, liquid fuel gas are absorbed easily, correct. Under high pressure, it results into multi-molecular layer on adsorbent surface, correct. Delta H adsorption is low and positive. So we should know that delta H is what? Not positive, it is actually negative. So the option D is the answer for question number 13. For question number 13, the answer is option D for the same. Delta H is negative. The answer is delta H is negative. So for this purpose, I told you that each and every line of the book, we should read thoroughly because we'll get incorrect questions. So again, from the class, you are learning not about these things, but how to approach for an engineering entrance exam. How to approach process of elimination. That is what your final learning is all about. Okay. And if you're not getting the answer, kindly do not worry. Okay. Because we are here to learn. This is just the beginning few class. This is the third class. Okay, the chemistry, the first class. Correct. So no need for you to worry at all. Now let us look at the first question in this. The half-life period of a first order reaction is 60 minutes. What percentage will be left over after 240 minutes? Okay. So for this question, I want everyone to write down the answer of this and then send it to me in WhatsApp. Now, let me see how many of you are doing this thing correctly. So I already got the correct answer from one student. So please send me the pick of the same. Okay, please send me the pick of the same. I'm waiting. So I got three answers now, all are correct answers. But guys, the idea is not to get the correct answer, okay? Idea is for you to try without fear. Fine, this is not your KSAT or the Comet K entrance thing. So please send it to me without fear. So this is a logical question. So I got seven answers now. Okay, and all are correct. So guys, there are two ways of doing this same question. The half-life period of first order reaction, 60 minutes. What percentage will be left over after 240 minutes? So I'll show you the traditional way of doing the question. First thing. Traditional way of doing the question. Okay. Traditional way, in the sense, we take what t half is equal to 60 minutes. Correct? And there is a formula for number of half lives. That is n form. Okay. T is equal to n into t half. T is equal to n into t half. For those who don't know, write down this formula. T is equal to n into t half. So what is our n? N is equal to t by t half. So 240 by 60 is equal to what? 4. So board exam you have to do like this. Okay. So this is the traditional way. Then what we do? Let the initial amount be 100. Correct? So what will be the amount? What will be the amount after n is equal to 4 half lives? Okay, that will be what? The initial by 2 power n. This is one more formula. So 100 by 2 power 4 is what? 100 by 16, that is nothing but 6.25%. Okay, this is the first way of doing the thing. This is a traditional approach. This is the traditional approach of doing things. Okay. But I just wanted not only this formula, but actually if we do like this, this is not the way to do in an entrance thing preparation. See guys, for an entrance preparation, I'll tell you what to do. Fine. So I think one of my students, not two of my students, I haven't opened. So I just muted my WhatsApp now. Okay. So the question here is what? How much percentage after 240 minutes you have to find? Correct? So initial, we will take it as what? Initial is what? 100%. Initial is what? 100%. And after 60 minutes, it will be what? 50% respectively. Similarly, after 120 minutes, it will be what? The half of this. After 180 minutes, it will be half of this, 12.5. So 240 minutes, it will be half of 12.5, that is nothing but 6.25%. So this is the actual way of solving this question. Okay, fast. Now let me check the remaining answers. Yes. So I think very good. So I think a lot of guys has got the correct answer. But for the guys who are not got the correct answer, okay, I don't want you to feel upset by any chance. First thing. Okay. Fine. Now you got the method. See, in any entrance session, the basic idea is what? We are coming here to learn new things and apply it. Okay. Not in a traditional manner. So first I want you to copy down this thing, the traditional way. Okay, traditional way. First you copy down this thing. Entrance thing is a different approach altogether. Okay, and chemistry, there are a lot of shortcuts which in the coming classes I'll be telling. Okay, in 2016 paper there are no much shortcuts. Okay, these are all pure theoretical thing, pure theory based thing. Okay, in 2016 paper mostly 80% of the questions here are mainly theoretical thing. And rest only 20% we can use a shortcut, that's all. Okay. And this is one of the problem which we can use the shortcut. So guys, just copy down this thing first. this initial by 2 power n. That's all. So this is applicable for all the kind of questions. So for those who didn't understand, initial I'm taking 100%. After 60%, how much will after 60 minutes, how much will remain 50%? 120, the half of the 25, 180, the half of that, then 240, the half of that. So this is very easy question to do. Now let us see some simple questions. Which of the following is not a colligative property? Second question. Osmotic pressure, optical activity, depression freezing point, elevation boiling point. Obviously, the answer is optical activity, not a colligative property. So this is again a very easy question. Option 2, B. Now, question number 4. When an electrolyte is dissociated in a solution, the Van Hove factor is what? So, when an electrolyte, this is again a theoretical question, when an electrolyte gets dissociates in a solution, the number of particles increases. Correct? So the I, what is I? The Van Hove factor, I is nothing but what? Number of particles after dissociation to the number of particles taken. To the number of particles taken. So that is nothing but what? I greater than 1 for dissociation. I greater than 1 for dissociation. That is the answer. So kindly copy down the same thing. When an electrolyte dissociates in a solution, number of particles increases. I is equal to number of particles after dissociation to number of particles taken. I greater than 1 for dissociation is the answer for the same. So please copy down the same thing. So I hope everyone has finished down this thing. Yeah, the 16th one will be good. The IUPAC name of the compound is what? 1-bromobutene, 2-bromobutene, bromobutene, 1-bromobut-3-ene. So guys, here we have number from this particular point, the bromine part. So this is 1, and this is 2, and this is our third, and this is our fourth one. Correct? So what bromo? One bromo. One bromo butte. One bromo butte, because there are four carbon atoms. There are four carbon atoms. Butane. Huh? But here there is a double bond, so obviously it is an alkene. So we have to see which is lesser, two or three. Obviously, two is lesser. One bromo butte two ene is the answer. This. Option A. Question number 16. Option A. One bromo butte two ene. That's all. So everyone just draw it and just mark it out. I recommend highly everyone to draw the thing, okay, and then number it. One bromo butane. So if anyone is having any doubt on this kind of IUPAC naming, okay, so please feel free to contact me once the session is over. Okay, please feel free to contact me once the session is over. I'll help you guys out. So now we will do the question number 26. If the bond energies of HHBr2 and HBr are 433, 192 and 364 kilojoules per mole, then delta H for the reaction is of that particular reaction is how much? So guys, again, this I will do it for you. Fine. One second, guys. Pen is not working. H2 plus the Br, 2 gives what? 2 HBr. This is the equation, correct? So this is 433 plus what? What is it given? This 192, and this is given as what? 364. So minus 2 into 364. So the answer is what? Minus 103 kilojoules. So please copy down the same thing. This is again a very easy question to do. This is a very easy question to do. So again, those are seeing it for the first time. Okay, again, you are learning some new things. In the entrance session, it is not our typical classroom things. Okay. So we here I'm taking some mix of something and then we are doing the thing. Then only we'll get the pattern. And guys, at least 4 to 5 question minimum will repeat if you do the last 10-year paper. Okay. And if you do the last 20-year paper, around 40% of the question will repeat. There is a pattern. At least the pattern will be same. We will know from each and every chapter what will be coming. So those are not good in organic chemistry. I don't want you to get worried. Okay. I don't want you to get worried. Physical chemistry is there. Inorganic chemistry is there. So I qualified by JE mains and advanced by giving more importance to physical chemistry and inorganic chemistry. Organic chemistry, I haven't focused that much because I always knew that that is not my strong point, but what is my strong point and which I am comfortable in learning? That you have to give very, very important. Okay. The first 5-6 chapters in class 12 are very easy to score full mark. To score full mark. Fine, guys. So I hope everyone has written down this thing. Okay. Then I'll go to the next 25th question. 25th question I'll just do. The number of oxygen atoms in 4.4 grams of carbon dioxide. Okay. Is how much? So guys, again, this I'll do it for you. First thing, molar mass of carbon dioxide. 12 plus 2 into 16, it is nothing but 44 respectively. And we all know W by M is equal to what? N by Na. What is this Na? Avogadro number. So this implies 4.4 by molar mass. 44 is equal to N by Na. N is 6.022 to 10 power 23, but guys, we are not doing a board exam. We don't need accurate answer. We just take assumption. So 6 into 10 power 23, I'm taking it. Fine. So what is our N value? I'll get N is equal to, I'll get 6 into 10 power 22. Upon solving, I'll get. Fine. And the question here is, what the oxygen atoms in carbon dioxide, how many oxygen atoms are there? In CO2, there are two oxygen atoms. Two oxygen atoms are there. Correct? So N is equal to what? Two times this thing, 6 into 10 power 22. So we'll get what? 1.2 into 10 power 23 respectively. One second, guys. 1.2 into 10 power 23. So that is the answer for this. Because of this thing, two oxygen atoms in the carbon dioxide molecule. So that's how we get this. So kindly copy down this thing. So the most possible error for us is we get this N value and we'll stop from this. Okay, but that is not true. So that is a trick in this. So once we do at least 10 papers, minimum of 10 papers, I am 100% sure that everyone will get to know the thing. Fine. So normally in any entrance coaching centers, what they will do is they'll teach you chapter by chapter. Fine. Chapter by chapter, and they'll do 2 to 3 questions based on each chapter. Just like the class. Fine. And we can do maximum of 3 to 4 past year paper, but the ranks are not produced like that. Okay, if we want to get the high rank, if we want to get the high rank, then we have to do minimum of 20 year paper. That I will do it for you. Okay, that I will do it for you. That's it. That's how you will benefit. Fine. So I will do all the questions. Okay. And I'll clear all your doubts as much as I can. Fine. So guys, once you copy down this thing, I will share you one more important thing before giving you a break. So I hope everyone has copied down.
Okay.
So I just want to tell you some small things before giving you a break. So guys, the importance of the CET exam. So when I was in your age, so that is, I think, some 14, 15 years back. Okay, 14 years back, we can take it out. So I had got two best friends. And out of three of us, one of the guy got IIT, that is me. Second guy got into NIT. The third guy got to an ordinary college. Okay. So then we met after some 3 or 4 years. Fine. So one of my best friend, so he asked us. Okay. So we all three partied together. We all enjoyed a lot. Okay. So he asked us one thing, like, you should have actually told me to study also. Yeah. Okay. I would also go into IIT or NIT at least. Fine. So the thing is that we can do all the play and fun. Okay, but the important thing is, if you are into a good college and if you get a good rank in the KSET, if you get a very good rank in the KSET, the fees of you will come around 10,000. Okay, to the max. If you're in general quota, 10,000 will come per year. And you'll get in an excellent college. Okay, so if you're just taking 10,000 per year, the 10,000 into 4 years, 40,000. Fine. Suppose if you are not getting in a good college, then there is something called Comet K. So Comet K fees, I think, around 90,000 per year. So in a good college like Ramya, that is fine. So again, it is coming around what? 3,60,000. But this is, see the difference. 40,000 and 3,60,000. Suppose if you are not getting a good college in KSET and Comet K, then the fees will come like 3 lakh per year. So 3 lakh into 4, 12 lakh. Plus some miscellaneous, it will come 15 lakh for the 4-year course. 15 lakhs it will come. Okay. So that is the reason in the beginning of the class I told you, if any of your friends are unable to join any online session, I'm not talking about my class itself, any other class it may be. But the only thing here is I will work for you guys. Okay. So I'm putting that much effort. Okay. It would be max or physics or chemistry. So chemistry, there are not really that shortcuts. There are real concepts in this, but I can actually pick you the questions which come for the exam. I can pick the questions and I can give to you. Once we solve the 10-year paper, which I'm sure all of us will do. Okay. I can literally pick up the question and give to you. This question will come for the exam. Okay, so that no entrance coaching center is providing you. Okay, so you understood this thing, and this 3 lakh will be for some college which don't have that much good faculties. But if you get KSET, 10,000 rupees and this thing, 40,000 rupees and 3,60,000 is a good difference. 3,20,000 rupees is the difference in this, in the KSET fees and the Comet K fees. Once you take this 3,60,000 is 15 lakh thing, what is the difference coming? Difference is huge. Around 11,40,000 is the fee difference here actually. 11,40,000. And once you take 40,000 and 15 lakh, it is almost 14,60,000 is the fee difference. So that is the reason. See, you have to study hard. Okay. And if you're financially very good, especially for the boys, you can tell your parents to buy you some good super bike for the same price instead of giving the college that money. Correct? Fine. And for the girls, you can buy a lot of pair of shoes and chappals and keep it with you. Fine. So that is the reason I'm telling you what. Kindly focus and give more importance to the KSET thing. Kindly get in CET itself. Okay. If not in CET, commit. It will have a huge impact financially. Okay. And it can fulfill all of your dreams also. So try to get in KSET, very good rank. That is the only reason which I am doing all the 20-year paper. You check out in any institute or any coaching center, they won't be willing enough to put this much amount of effort to do each and every question. Okay. They will give the students homework. Okay, 50, 60 questions, they'll give homework with the options, not with the solutions again. Okay, but here what I'm telling you, I am going to do all the questions. So that is a difference. And we got plenty of time. I think it will be on June, July. The Comet K will be July or August. But the CET will be pushed to June from the sources which I got. Okay. So I don't want you to get worried. And chemistry, please don't get worried that if you do 20-year paper, last 20-year paper, you will get 95% of the questions. Trust me, this thing. 95% max, we cannot tell. Physics, we cannot tell. But the only thing is, I have to do the 95% of the questions. Okay. Which I'm sure I will do it. And I'll make sure that you are into the topmost rank. And you will get into this, the KSET thing. Okay. The KSET rank you should get. Fine. So that's what I am also focusing much more on. Fine, guys. So I hope that you will all utilize this time for the benefit of you. So take a 10-minute break. So guys, so let us start the class now. Fine. So let us take question number 27. In the reaction, FeOH thrice gives Fe3++3OH-. If the concentration of OH- ions is decreased by 1/4 times, then the equilibrium concentration of Fe3+ will increase by how many times? Okay, so we have to be very clear in this question. If the concentration of OH- ions is decreased by 1/4 times, so OH- ions, how many are there now? Actually, 3 are there. So obviously, we have to do what? 1/4 the whole cube of OH-. So 1/64 times. Correct, is decreased by 1/64 times. So to maintain equilibrium, we have to multiply by what? 64 times. Okay, so this is the what? This is the modern way of doing this thing without using any traditional approach of doing this. But if you want me to do the traditional approach, then I'd write the whole equation, then do it. So see in question number 27, the concentration of OH- is decreased by 1/4 times. So 3 OH-, so 1/4 the whole cube. So that is nothing but 1/4 cube, that is 1/64. So 1/64 times it is decreased. Correct, totally. So we have to multiply by 64 times to maintain the equilibrium. So the option is C. The answer is C for this question. So this 27th one, I am not gonna do it on the board. Okay, see, do it on the board. It is a board exam way of doing. That is not gonna help us in doing the entrance exam. 28th question. The correct statement regarding entropy is, at absolute zero temperature, entropy of a perfectly crystalline solid is zero. So obviously the first option, option A, is correct. Why? Because what is the third law of thermodynamics? Third law of thermodynamics is nothing but at absolute zero temperature, entropy of a perfectly crystalline solid is zero. So that is nothing but our third law of thermodynamics. So option A is the correct answer. So guys, kindly go back to your class 11 thermodynamics chapter and just read the first law of thermodynamics, second law of thermodynamics, third law. Kindly make a note of all the laws. Fine. Now. Thirty-eighth question. The bivalent metal ion having maximum paramagnetic behavior among the first transition series element is what? So this I will do it for you. So what is the condition of a paramagnetic thing that we should first know? Paramagnetic condition. More the number of unpaired electron, what more it will show paramagnetic in nature. More the number of unpaired electron, more it will show paramagnetic in nature. So now we have to see among these things which will be more unpaired. Let us take Mn2+. So what is the electronic configuration of this thing? 3d5 4s 0. 3d5 4s 0. So just put the box. D means 5 should come. 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 3d5. So 1 2 3 4 and 5. 4s, this is 4s. Now let us take Cu+. 3d10
4s0 1 2 3 4 5. Fill this thing. 10 is there, so it is completely paired electron. I'm not doing the 4s because 4s is same. Next thing, sc2+. 3d0, 4s0. I'm not even bother to draw it. Cu2+. 3d10, 4s0. So again, that will be same as this above. So obviously, it is clear as what this will be same as this. So Mn2+ has got 5 unpaired electrons. So it shows maximum paramagnetic nature. So guys, the answer of this is Mn2+. So kindly draw the same. So please note down the same thing. Mn2+. So let us do the question number 31, a direct question. Okay. So copper metal, the composition of this is what the first option is, Cu2+ Fe. So these are all direct questions. Okay. So which I will discuss when, once you guys are in the class. Okay. So this is some of the easiest question, which I'm just leaving it out. And let me now just see 34th question, which is true regarding nitrogen. Which is true regarding nitrogen? Less electronegative. N is highly electronegative. First thing, nitrogen is highly electronegative. Okay, nitrogen highly electronegative. Third most electronegative element in that particular group. Has low ionization enthalpy. That is also wrong. It has got a very high ionization enthalpy. D orbitals are available. So those who studied that chapter has a basic common sense that it does not have D orbitals. No D orbitals. Every to form P pi bonds with itself. Very true. Okay. Due to the absence of D orbitals in nitrogen, it forms the P pi bond with itself. So the answer is D. So for you, I'll just write it down. Due to the absence of